Good morning, Divers. Noel's Garden Tractors and Firewood here. And today, it's not very nice out today. It's kind of wet and cold. And anyway, I'm going to try and get into the woods and push that pile of stuff where I throw my old bark and the sawdust and old bits and pieces of trees in. I want to push it back a bit. But I want to do a little update here on the poor man's power steering kit that we had put in the MF-16 yesterday. And this is the MF-14, so it's basically the same thing. Anyway, this one has the three rib tires on it on the front. And they were at 10 pounds. So we put them to 15. And my son had put the four-man tire steering kit in last night. Very nice of him to do that. He took the tractor in and he did the oil change and greased everything up and did the check over on it, so this tractor is done. So that's a great thing. We're a little step ahead up there now. Thanks to him for that. So we put this tire steering kit in the MF-16 yesterday. And we again topped up the tires and stuff, and we really didn't think it did a whole lot, just the bare power steering kit. But once we put the air in, it seemed to work really well. And what we found was that when you're going along and you steer to the right or the left, you had to manually steer it that way, of course. But you also had to manually steer it back to straight. So what we found with the 16 was when you steer to the right or left and let go of the wheel, it would automatically come back to straight on its own, which is what it should do. So the MF-14, I noticed now this morning, it's now doing the same thing too. You always had to manually steer one way or the other, but you always had to manually steer back. And it's working good here this morning. You can steer to one way or the other and let the wheel go, and it'll come back to center on its own. So obviously easier. I'll see if I can do a little demonstration here. It's a bit noisy with the old thing, but anyway, here we go here. Doing it, I'm holding the hammer with one hand and got my hand up with the other one. It's doing it on its own. So I don't know whether the power steering kit does anything or not, but maybe it does. Oh, that's pretty nice. With the turn on. Well, you really can't see in there, but you can get through. holes in the path for some reason. I think this tractor dug holes when it was trying to pull the tree out that was across here. All right, there's the other end of the path. You really can't see it, but it is. I used it the other day, so it's going to work. All right. See if I can get you set up here somewhere, and I'll get back to you in a minute. All right, there we go. I got you set up in my handy-dandy camera holding thing, which is called a tree. And you may notice that it's moving a bit because it's just a small little tree. It's about an inch and a half trunk on it. And it's windy today, so you might see a little going back and forth, I think. Anyway, away I go. Thank you. there now. I just hope I don't get a flat, because I had been putting old wood and stuff like that in there that had nails in it. Anyway, we'll find out, I guess. It's great to have that done. Another little step ahead. All right, I'll get back to you in a minute. All right, we're going to see if we can get out through the new path. Oh, the grass is not very nice, though. I'm sure I'll have to have the plow angled. For the stack too, I guess. Stack getting into the tree. There. Sorry about the moving around. It's just kind of the way it is. High range now. Do a little loop around this tree here. That works good. Cruise ship in today. That's the only one. Have a good day. Well, good afternoon, viewers. It's a little bit later after me being out in the path with the MF-14 bulldozer, garden tractor. Anyway, it's a nasty old day today. The rain's going sideways. So, I'm going to sit in my garage with the fireplace going, or a wood stove, I guess you'd call it. And I've got me lantern on, look at that. There now. The ambiance, I guess. Oh, I'll sit you down here somewhere and I'll have a quick little chat, and it'll be today's entertainment. I didn't think I'd make a video today, but here we are. Get you turned around a little more here, maybe. You can. I'm kind of hanging you off the back of the John Deere tractor with the seat cover on it. There's my Canadian flag here. See that? There now. I guess you can see and hear me, hopefully. Dumping spot in the woods there. You might know that, I guess, by watching a few of the videos. So. And I couldn't get to it because of the tree that was in the way, so chopped up the tree and hauled that out and cut it up and all that kind of stuff. And I get in there, I wanted to get in with the bulldozer to push all that stuff back. I've been dumping stuff in there for years. It's surprising how it disintegrates and it just seems to disappear. But anyway, a bit of it there. So I pushed it all out as far as I could, so I've got a nice big spot there now to dump some more bark and pieces and sawdust and things like that there. So the next task will be to clean up where I was cutting wood. There's an area there that's all covered in sawdust and bits and pieces, so that's got to get all cleaned up before winter. And Tuesday kind of sounds like it might be a nice day, so I'll try and do it then. And hopefully we'll get some video of that. And the other thing that got done was my son, God, he's a great young fella. He fixed up one of the tractors there for service last night, and we finished it off today. And what else did we do? Well, we took the MF-12 in, the one that has the loader on it. We serviced it all up, oil change, greased up and looked at things, and checked the rear ends. And then we had it done, so we took in Grunt, or sometimes I call it Frankie, and it's very simple to do. There's only a few grease nipples and the oil in it wasn't too bad looking, so we're not going to bother with the oil in it this year. It hardly runs, you know, they might only get a couple hours a year on the thing. So. And we checked all the tire pressures and all the things stuff, so that was a great day to get that done. And we got the 6 foot, my son did that. He took his Ford 1210 and picked up the 6 foot finish mower and put it away for the winter. So we're getting there. And the weather apparently is supposed to be reasonable this week now instead of unreasonable. So maybe by this time next week we should have everything done and completed. Hopefully, maybe. And then on November 1st, I can hibernate. Anyhow, there you go. There's another video. Like I say, I don't know. I probably said I wasn't going to make one today, but I just couldn't help myself. I had to make one, so. Anyway, I'm going to sit by my fire and drink my coffee. And it doesn't sound like anybody's coming for a visit today, so that's kind of too bad. But if anybody can get here within the next half hour or so, we'll come and have a visit. All right, that's good enough for now. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you all later.